Poppin, everybody. Welcome back to your favorite YouTube show and your favorite cooking show. On today's Who's Up, guys, it is Eid again. I remember in the last video, I was telling you guys that we celebrate twice a year. This is the other one. This is the one that we actually have to sacrifice an animal. I thought it was the other one. I don't know why. It's probably because it was after Ramadan, but it is this one. And in this one, I am at home with my family. So I am going to be making some stuff today. I'm going to make bolani. So I decided to record with you guys because we get the OG, my mom, in it. So yeah, it's going to be super exciting and I cannot wait. So I have not all my ingredients here, but I have the ingredients to start my flour, because for bolani, we're going to, you normally make it from scratch. We make the flour from scratch, I think that's how you say it. We make the flour from scratch, so we're going to use, of course, some flour. We got some oil here, and then we have some cumin seeds. I believe, yeah, this is cumin seed. We have some cumin seeds here. I got my salt and my baking powder. You can also use baking soda if you want. And then I have one egg to crack in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and start measuring. Of course, guys, use what you're gonna need for your meat, the amount of people you're gonna cook for. We're gonna cook for a lot of people, so I'm gonna literally use what I need to cook for those people. And then I'm gonna go ahead, before I start that though, I'm gonna go ahead and cut my potatoes into, I'm gonna dice them up into cubes so we can throw it in the hot water. That way it gets cooked faster and we mush it up to put it inside the bolani. Potatoes, we're gonna cut this big.
That's big. It's good.
Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and do that with all the potatoes and throw them in the bag. I already have water boiling, guys. Make sure you guys have water boiling prior. Oh wow, that light is so much brighter. Thank you, mom. So we're just gonna go ahead and cut all of these up. Okay, guys, so the potatoes are all ready. We're gonna go ahead and take it to the stove and let these bad boys boil up. Oh my god, it's so hot, guys, be careful. Okay, there you go. Wow. We're just gonna let these boil up. And now we're gonna go ahead and go to the garden and rip out some gandanas. It's basically these. I don't know the English. Wait, I don't know the English word name. I think it's called wheatgrass, if I'm not mistaken. But we're gonna get these and we're gonna go ahead and get some fresh mint and I believe cilantro. So to the garden we go. Okay, guys. So this is my parents' backyard. It goes around, and this is one of my childhood houses because we moved to three different places. So this is one of them, and my mom loves her fruit trees and growing her tomatoes, tomatoes, all of that. So we're here by all these beautiful mint leaves, guys. This mint plant is so beautiful, guys. And fun fact about mint plants, that they spread. They're like strawberry plants. Like, once you plant them, the motherfuckers spread. So with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and just cut off these mints. I'm gonna clean them up on there. Actually, I'm gonna go on that side and get them from there. Oh my god, there's so much bugs. Okay. Okay, guys. So these are the gandanas that I was telling you guys about, by the way. We have to get some of these as well. Mom said we need some. So we're just gonna go ahead and cut them up from there. And we'll clean them up when we get inside, of course. I don't know how much she wants me to. But this is giving me so much memories, guys, from when I was in Pakistan. Me and my sister used to go to this huge landfill space and we would just like pick our spinach for my mom to cook. And it's just like, it's different. That country life is different. But I'm a city girl. I love the city. So we're just gonna go ahead, guys, and carefully cut these beautiful. I left out a few ingredients. I got some yeast, of course, guys. Yeast is very important where you're making dough. And then I got some warm milk and I got some, it's not like warm, it's like lukewarm. And then this is like lukewarm water. We're gonna go ahead and start with the water. I use about this much. I'm gonna feed like about 7-8 people, guys. And these people eat a lot, so I'm technically feeding about 10-12 people. So I have to make a lot. I'm gonna put put that to the side, and then after that I'm going to put baking soda in it. I'm using this teaspoon. You basically put, like, I'd say like 2.5 or 3 of these, but I am gonna go ahead and put about this much in there. Oh, it's so sweet. And then mom, guys, I need my mom's help. What do I do next?
I have to leave it for five seconds.
Okay, so we let the baking.
Put salt too?
I have not put salt yet. Put salt?
Yeah.
How much? 1 tablespoon?
This.
Oh, the big one? Okay. So for the salt, guys, I'm gonna use this massive spoon and just fill it up. I'm gonna do it over here. And then my mom said, guys, this, you leave this about for 5 minutes, just for everything to fizz up and dissolve together or whatever. Let it do its thing, basically. I'll see you guys in 5 minutes. I forgot the yeast again. I have not done dough in so long. I can't believe myself. So I'm just gonna put 2 tablespoons of this, and then we're gonna let it sit for 5 minutes. And it looks like they're ready. The fork is going in, stabbing right through. They are ready. We're gonna turn these off, and then we're gonna mush them. But before we mush them, we're gonna go ahead and finish doing this dough, because it has to sit for a little bit and we want our dough to be good. The dough, guys. Now we're gonna go ahead and basically fill this up about, let's say 75%. We're gonna put some milk in there. I'd say like about that much milk should be okay. And then, is that good?
You can put all.
Put all of it?
Yeah, okay. It's not bad.
So should I just put it in here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we're gonna throw that 75 or whatever. You guys saw the measurement of the water. I cannot talk today. I'm gonna throw that water in there. I'm gonna throw this milk in there. And then we're gonna go ahead and put some cumin in there. I'm gonna put like about, let's say like 2 of these small spoons like that.
Okay.
Put this to the side. We're gonna crack our eggs in there. Go ahead and put some oil in there. How much oil, mom?
1 spoon.
Okay. So according to mom's recipe, we're gonna put 2 spoons here. Guys, by the way, my mom will be in the video, but she's being shy because she's saying she's not ready. But it's okay, I'll let her slide this time. Okay, guys, so we're gonna just go ahead and whisk everything together. Get a little close up of this one. Okay. And then we're gonna go ahead and start putting in. You want me to use a spoon for this? Okay. We're gonna start putting in our flour.
Full.
Full? Okay. Like being scary with it. Okay. And then we're gonna mix it along the way. We're not gonna use our hand, guys, until it is completely unliquidy. Because I have nails, guys. You know what I mean? So we want to avoid as much as possible. I'm gonna go ahead and mix it like that. Let's not get things messy, guys. Sorry, can make so much mess. It's okay, she can talk in the video, yeah.
Yeah.
She can talk in the video. She's gonna be a Tom and Jerry in the back. It's starting to happen. This is getting to what we want, guys. We want it to be like this. Not like this, but you know, this is how you know it's working. Some more. Okay. Guys, this is one of my favorite dish, but it takes so long. So I went ahead and got down and dirty. I started using my hands because you eventually have to. But I basically put 4 cups of flour all together. And the water, guys, we're gonna just keep adding in water throughout until we get a certain consistency of, like, you know, that good dough. I don't know how to explain it, but I'm gonna show it to you guys. But right now it looks like this. You know, so we definitely 100% need more water, but this is such a mess, guys. This is why I don't make this too much, because it takes so long and it just gets so so messy, but it is so worth it sometimes. So I'm gonna get this out because it's bothering me. But actually, I'm just gonna scoop the water here. There you go. I'm gonna do what my mom used to do. I used to watch her make this so much, guys. But sometimes she would just literally dip her hand in the water because the flour would be so annoying and all in your finger. But we're gonna just go ahead and just keep kneading it until we get that ball. I will be right back with you guys. My mom has helped me out because, man, it's so hard to get a hold of this sometimes, but we did it. The dough is ready and I'm about to show it to you guys in a second. So how it looks, look at this bad boy. So this is what it should look like, guys, basically when it's all clean, nice, like, you know what I mean, like that. Basically, we're gonna cover this up and just let it sit for a little bit. And we're gonna go ahead and start cutting up the gandanas. I'm gonna just keep calling it in my English, guys. I'm gonna just keep cutting, I think it's wheatgrass. We're gonna keep cutting the wheatgrass. We're gonna go ahead and cut the wheatgrass and mix it up with the potatoes. I'm gonna say tomatoes. All right, we'll be right back. Guys, so I'm here at the cutting board. Guys, my brother just told me, my older brother told me that this is called chives, not wheatgrass. So it's chives. And the substitution would be like green onions. So yeah, we're gonna just go ahead, guys, and cut these super, super tiny like this. Okay, guys, we're gonna put these in the bolani, which I guess the closest thing I could explain to you would be like a huge empanada, a huge flat empanada. Yeah. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut all of these up and throw them into the bowl. Cutting up my chives, we're gonna go ahead and throw them in there. And then the mint leaves, my mom said to just basically make them leafy and not cut them up because I guess they're gonna get like dark, right? They're gonna get dark, yes. So we just want to basically make them all leafy. And then I believe we mix that with this. By the way, guys, you know me, I normally use my E-Nice olive oil, which I do not have with me today. I travel with a lot, but I'm not gonna travel with my olive oil. So we're just gonna go ahead and put in 2 tablespoons of the olive oil, and then we're gonna use this Hervisa seasoning. Guys, this is almost like the Hervisa seasoning that I use, but my one is more bigger though. My one is like more light. This is like grinded up. So I'm curious to know how this one tastes. But I'm gonna do it over here just so it doesn't get over there too much. But we use like a good big spoon of this, and then we're gonna do a half spoon of crushed pepper. Okay, I'm gonna open this up, guys. Looks like it's gonna be a mission. So there you go. You're gonna do a half spoon of that. And then for the salt, guys, use very, very tiny salt. I should use a teaspoon salt, but I just have it to my hand. But I'm gonna use like very, very tiny, because when you mix this together, it is going to it's gonna get very tiny. So we're gonna go ahead and just start mixing everything together. Get all the seasoning and all the oils. Oh, this smells so good, guys. Then after this is super mixed, then does this look good, mom?
I have to be that little soft.
A little soft?
Yeah.
It's a bit soft. I think I might need to put a little bit more olive oil in it. You think it's good? It's good. It's good, guys. So we're just gonna go ahead and throw in the mint, and then we're gonna mix the mint in, and we're gonna set this to the side and start getting our potato bowl ready. We're gonna make chives. We normally make chives bolani and potato bolani. Those are like the two most popular ones. We're gonna make those two. We're gonna just go ahead, guys, and drain all the water from the potatoes out. I am gonna go ahead and cut an onion and throw it in the pan over there with all my seasonings, which I will show you once I've cut the onion. And then we're gonna go ahead and mix the, I keep calling it tomato, potatoes. We're gonna mix it in with the potatoes and all of our seasonings, so. Put our onions in here, just be careful because they will make some type of, there you go. The noise of a good homemade meal. Go ahead and mix this up. That's pretty mixed up. My mom handed me this guy.
Oh my god.
I am just gonna use this for now. I feel like this is much better. We're gonna let this sit in here, guys, until it is moist, and then we're gonna throw some water and all of our seasonings. If you wanna follow me, I will show you guys the seasonings that we're gonna use for the potatoes. We're gonna use this coriander, we're gonna use some salt, and then we're gonna use some black pepper. And I minced up some little green peppers here, guys. You know, these are my favorite little green peppers. I minced some of these up, and yeah, once the onion is ready, we're gonna just throw all these in there with it and get the potatoes ready, guys. Everyone is freaking hungry, and they hate me because I'm doing this video, but whatever. The onions should literally look like this if you can get it a little close. Not too normally, normally I make it caramelized, guys, but today we're gonna leave it soft like that. Like I said, you just want it to literally just soften up. And then we're gonna go ahead and put in 3 spoons of the coriander. Guys, that just adds such a great scent to everything. And then we're gonna do 1 spoon of the black pepper. And we're gonna do, Mom, 1 or 2 spoons of salt. Okay, 2 guys, good thing I asked. There you go. 2 spoons of salt. And then we're gonna throw in our pepper that we cut up. This is such a cute little spoon. I'm gonna put this back in there. And we're gonna throw in our cilantro, guys. I cut up some cilantros when the camera was not rolling. But my mom told me. Yes, mom.
Turmeric.
Turmeric? Okay, yeah. Guys. Ooh, you guys know I love turmeric. Let's definitely put some turmeric in here on this side. Okay. My mom has so much seasonings. And then how much do I put in this, mom?
1 spoon.
Okay. And then we're gonna put in 1 spoon, guys, of ground turmeric. And we're gonna mix everything up. And behind the scenes, guys, I also, what my mom did, I'm gonna give her the credit. She went ahead and peeled the potatoes, guys. And then we're just gonna go ahead and throw our, oh my God. We're gonna throw our potatoes in there and just basically mush it up in here. We want this to look like mashed potatoes. So you either use this or use something that's, you know, those mushers, guys. We don't have that over here. But you just use something and just basically mush it all the way up. And we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit of water because we want this to be, like I said, a mashed potato. So we want it to be like moisty and textury like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and get to the mission, guys, and mush this up, and we'll be right back. Guys, after everything is done, you basically put flour on your counter like this, and then the dough just roll into a little roll like that, like my mom has, and you just start cutting them and basically start making these little rolls, because these are what we're going to flatten out and make big into almost like a pizza dough. And then that's when we're gonna start doing the filling on half of them, as I will show you. And yeah, so while my mom and brother here making these little balls to, you know, go over with, this is what we use, by the way, guys. use this. I forgot what it's called in English. A roller? It's like a pastry roller, I believe, yeah. So we use that and a little roller. Just a roller, I guess. So we're just gonna use that and flatten out with that. But before that, we have to cover that up so it can basically, how would I explain it? Basically, you let it sit so it can like gain more, I don't know, guys. It's a weird thing
so
that,
raise.
So it can raise. There you go, that's what it was. It's a weird thing that flowers do or floors do, whatever the frick it's called. But yeah, we're just gonna let it chill for a little bit and let it raise up and we'll be right back. Oh, and by the way, guys, I have the pan over there heating up. I'm gonna actually go over there and show you guys what kind of pan we use. You can just use a regular flat skillet or you can buy this, which we bought. Okay, guys, so we got my ugly brother here.
Best looking child in the family is here.
Guys, here he goes.
So maybe he's gonna go behind the camera. That's how it works.
So right, here guys. He is, guys. He's definitely an amazing cook. I will give him that. But of course, thanks to my mom, we can't give him too much credit.
The easiest way to make this bigger is use plenty of flour. Don't be shy. People say don't, but I say do. Okay, that's how we do. And we're just gonna roll it. Quick. You gotta be quick. Your hands have to be quick with this, or else it's not gonna stretch as much. And then you can always get the flour out. Simple, right?
Yep.
Simple, right? It's pretty simple. So that's it. One is stretched already. It's ready for the bolani. You just leave it there. I guess I'll let Bibi fill that one out.
I'm gonna start filling it out, guys. Already, we're gonna go ahead and... So what you basically do, guys, is put the... By the way, guys, I cut my finger, shake my head. That was a very sharp knife. So I am literally one-handed right now. But you basically just take the potatoes and you just spread it around here on one half. Like this. It's good to have a little water, guys, because the water will prevent the potatoes from sticking on your fingers and it will make your life so much easier. So.
You know what else would make your life easier, guys? Not having long nails like that.
Guys, I'm, you know what? Kidding, you know? Will make your life easier? Not being a hater. Not being a hater. I am a woman full of talent. As you guys know, I can do things with nails. Makes it a little harder, guys, but what's life, you know, without
what's
being hard? Okay. Bada bing, bada boom.
My second one is gonna be ready too, for you to fill up.
Oh my God, he's going fast, guys.
I told you.
Whew. Okay, so after this, guys, you just basically, I'm gonna go wash my hands, guys, so it does not get everywhere, so I will be right back. I had put dough on the bottom because the last one was so hard to get out. But for this one, we're gonna do the chives. I'm gonna go ahead and grab a nice handful of chives and just spread it across here.
And then
the name sounds more freaking exciting and posh though, 100%. So this should be good chives, guys, and then we're just gonna go ahead, spread it out. So make sure you guys leave an inch on the bottom because that's where we're gonna stick the other top to. And we're gonna bring this over.
Have you told them the translation? Have you given them the translation of gandana?
What would be the translation?
Basically, it would mean like not dirty.
Gandana. That's true, guys. So. Gandana. Yeah, it honestly don't make sense, guys. Gandana in our language means not dirty.
Gandana.
So I guess we're eating the not dirties. We're gonna go ahead and go to the stove, guys, and see if that thing is cooking. Make sure you guys have your spatula, of course. It's almost, you guys wanna turn it around when it's like a golden, a brownish, like that. You don't want it to be too dark, but you want it to be just like that. I'm gonna go ahead and put my chive one over here. And then we're just gonna basically do that with all of the rolls. And yeah, I'll get to you guys when it's done. So I'm just checking up on my bolani, and this is a red bee. So basically, guys, oh my goodness. Let me not burn myself. So basically, this is the most it should, like, you know, get brown and crisp. But this right here is perfect, guys. And I put my chai one on here already. This should be almost good to flip soon as well. Actually, it's good to flip right now. Let's flip this bad boy over. Oh my god, guys, I'm gonna get it in the spatula because I do not know how my mom does this, but I am not gonna burn myself. So I'll guys, so we're almost done with these bolanis, and honestly takes a while, especially if you're doing it by yourself. Oof. But guys, look at this. My nails are freaking yellow because it's turmeric. This one isn't because my finger was cut. Oh my god, which hurts, by the way. But this one is like all yellow. Thank god I'm getting my nails done. Sheesh. Okay guys, so we are here. Normally I have a guest that will try out my food, but today, since I'm home, we have my brother here, and he already know how this shit tastes, guys, but we're just gonna eat together, and yeah, you guys are gonna see our reactions.
Today she has a real fat ass eating with her, so.
Yes, guys, I do. You wanna share this half potato one?
Absolutely. Give me.
And then we're gonna do half of the chives, of course. Ooh, guys, I have not had our bolani in so long.
See how crispy that skin is? It's thin, crispy, and it's
Guys, I'm looking flavors. At chives. It's just literally, these are full of flavors. And over here, guys, this is something called chutney, which I guess you guys will call it almost chimichurri, but this is the authentic Afghan version, which is literally cilantro, small green pepper, and this salt and pepper and garlic, of course.
A little bit of vinegar.
And then I'm gonna put some for him here.
There we go. I thought you were just gonna but no. I will go right in.
I'll put some more seconds.
Alright, you wanna take the bite together? You wanna take it together?
Yeah. Oh my god, okay.
All right. Cheers.
Cheers to bolani, guys. Wow. That chutney came out good.
This is childhood. These are memories. Nothing can take this away.
Telling you guys nothing.
Oh man, it's a little spicy.
It is, it's good though. It's good spicy. And this right here, guys, this white thing is our homemade yogurt mixed with dry mint and some salt as well. And this is just one of my favorite, guys. This is literally, we grew up on these and we will forever carry this recipe to our grave and beyond. Well guys, thank you guys so much for being here. We're gonna go ahead and eat the food. The rest of the family is also gonna sit down. But yeah, thank you guys for being here, and if you haven't already, make sure you go like, comment, share, and subscribe.